All right, continuing on with our dosing calculations, I'm on problem 4, which deals with how to calculate dosing based on a patient's weight. So in this particular problem, the patient weighs 150 pounds and the order is for 0.3 milliliters per kilogram of body weight. So you can already see we're gonna have to convert pounds to kilograms. So let's go ahead and do that first. So 150 pounds, and then 1 kilogram has 2.2 pounds. This is a conversion factor that you absolutely have to know, and you're gonna be using it repeatedly when you're doing dosing calculations. So this will give me kilograms, right? How much the patient weighs in kilograms. And then the order is for 0.3 milliliters per kilogram. So if we take 1 kilogram, 0.3 milliliters per kilogram, then our kilograms cross out and we're left with milliliters. Now pay close attention to this question, right? They asked us how many milliliters should the patient get. It also told us to round to the nearest tenth. It's really important to pay attention to a rounding instruction in the question. Sometimes it will tell you to round to the nearest whole number. Sometimes it'll tell you to round to the nearest tenth. You've got to make sure you pay attention to that and do exactly that, because you can do all your calculations correctly, and then if you round wrong at the end, you're gonna get the problem wrong. So we definitely don't wanna get the problem wrong. All right, so when we do this, we should get our milliliters. So if I get out my handy dandy calculator here and I take 150, divided by 2.2, multiply times 0.3, I get 20.454545, like repeating on and on. Because I'm rounding to the nearest tenth, I would end up with 20.5 milliliters. Not 20.45, right? And not just 20, we need to go to the tenth, so it ends up being 20.5 milliliters in this problem. All right, so we'll pick it up with the fifth problem next. All right, now I'm gonna go over problem 5, which is another problem where we're calculating the dose based on the patient's weight, but it's a little more complicated and we're gonna have to go through multiple steps to kind of work through the problem. So in this particular problem, the doctor has ordered 12 milligrams of a medication per kilogram per day, and it needs to be divided into doses every 8 hours, okay? Our child weighs 22 pounds, and what's available in terms of the medication is 200 milligrams in 5 liters. So the question is how many milliliters do we administer per dose? So not for the whole day, but per dose. So we know our child weighs 22 pounds and our order is in kilograms. So right off the bat, we're gonna have to convert to kilograms. So we're going to take the child's weight, 22 pounds, we're going to multiply times 2.2 pounds in 1 kilogram, and that will give us the child's weight in kilograms, okay? And then we know we're giving 12 milligrams per kilogram for a day. So if we take that, for each kilogram, we're going to be giving 12 milligrams. And if we do this math, we end up with, well, first of all, we cross off our kilograms and we should end up with milligrams per day. We end up with 120 milligrams for the day. But our question is per dose versus for the day. And we also need to know the milliliters, okay? So we're giving 120 milligrams over a 24-hour period, but we really want to know how much we need to give every 8 hours, because that's what's ordered. And so we're going to cross off these hours and we're going to end up with 40 milligrams per dose. So every 8 hours, we're going to give that child 40 milligrams. But again, we're asking for milliliters. So that's where we have to look at the medication we have available in what concentration. So we take the 40 milligrams and we have 200 milligrams in 5 milliliters. So I want the milligrams to cross off and I want to end up with milliliters. So I'm going to put the 200 milligrams on the bottom, put 5 milliliters on top, cross off my milligrams, do that math, and I end up with 1 milliliter per dose, which is every 8 hours. So again, I know it's a lot of different steps. We're really just trying to go with the units of measure we're given and then work our way towards what's ordered to be able to answer the question. So just to review with this one again, we took the weight, we calculated the child's weight into kilograms, and then we found out how many milligrams they needed for the day. And then we multiplied this times 8 hours to find out how much we give per dose. And then we took that with the medication we have available to find out how many milliliters we need. So that is problem 5, probably the hardest one that I'm going through today, but we've got a few more that I'm going to go through. So hang in with me and we'll do some more. Thanks.